Metaphysics, A Bridge to Ekankar by Thomas Flammer. Page 53 to page 63. On the physical plane, there are five broad energy manifestations of the audible life stream that reflect the light and sound principles. First, there is the plasma of outer space beyond the atmosphere. There is a high vibratory rate manifestation that can and does act as a vehicle for energy of lower vibratory rates. Second, there is static energy, normally balanced, that flows only to re-establish the balanced preservation stage between elemental energy forms. Third, there is magnetic reflective energy created by a higher vibratory energy form as an enveloping balancing factor. The energy flow is generally counter to that which created it. Fourth, there is electromagnetic energy generally collected within a flow vehicle as it cuts across a magnetic field. Gravity can generally be considered an interrelated bireflective energy characteristic between the secondary magnetic reflective energy and the primary electromagnetic energy that creates it. The interplay of these two energy forms, as well as the static energy form of the item being acted upon, creates a preservation stage of attraction between the energy forms as a countermeasure to the displacement effects by the rotational motions, approximately 90 degrees to each other of the Earth on its own axis and around the Sun. Fifth, there is resonating electromagnetic energy. This can be a manifestation of the light principle or the sound principle, as well as both. If it has both, then it is a reflection of the audible live stream of itself. There are many experiments being carried out throughout the physical world to find the secret of the purported life force within the resonating electromagnetic energy. Einstein equation of E=mc² denotes the destructive principle of harmonic energy utilizing the light principle only. This is not a clean, swift change due to the lack of sound principle. When the high sound principle is used alone as a destructive harmonic energy, there is generally a swift, clean change. When the destructive harmony energy utilizes both light and sound, there is complete conversion to formless energy without form residue. All creative and destructive energies are functional states that appear as non-stable principles, but are in fact finite quantity form expressions. Pure God energy is an infinite formless expression of stateless non-polar beingness. All things work within the spiritual law of harmonics and cannot exist without its ensuing energy forms. Both the light principle and the sound principle within the audible life stream have fascinated individuals through the ages, Aristotle made comment on the analogy between color, light, harmonics, and sound, harmonics. Arcimboldo, 16th century Italian artist, devises color, light, harmonics based on a scale similar to the musical sound scale. Johann Kepler, 16th to 17th century, German astronomer, astrologist, and mathematician, also philosophized on the interrelationships of light and sound, and his writing, The Harmony of the Universe. Louis-Bertrand Castel, 17th to 18th century, French Jesuit mathematician, is generally accepted as the first to present color music as an art form using fixed and variable light as the main structure. He proposed it within his 1720 presentation, La Musique en Couleur. Joan V. von Goethe, 18th to 19th century, German poet, writer, classical dramatist, and philosopher, also did a whole study on the color, light, harmonic theorem. Color, light music has lagged behind sound music because of the complex technology required to produce it, as well as the rudimentary changes within sound music concepts and presentation. During the last 50 years, there has been a gradual blending of both color music and sound music to create not only visual and auditory effect, but as well a superimposed empathetic response by individual consciousness to a synthetic low manifestation of the audible life stream, light and sound. Sound music is usually a good starting place for eventually moving into the combined light and sound form. Herbert Weinstock, contemporary American editor and writer on music and musicians, offers a comprehensive chronological presentation of Western world sound music evolution in his book, What Music Is, published in 1966. Shri Paul Twitchell gave a lecture entitled The Effect of Music on People and Government at the 1971 Utah Seminar on Ekankar in Salt Lake City. In this lecture, he spoke on the control of cultural units by designing leaders through the public presentation of carefully selected musical composition. The blending of color music and sound music will be even more devastating when it will be used to control, direct, manipulate, and condition multitudes of individual consciousness through mass media outlet. The Trimurti principles of creation, preservation, and destruction will always prevail in the lower negative world as long as ignorance of the spiritual law of harmonics is used as an excuse for the willful power intrusion and seizure of any individual's physical, emotional, mental, and spiritual beingness. Out of the primary spiritual law of harmonics, seven secondary corollary laws descend. listed in their order of manifestation. There are many more, but these seven are paramount and the lower worlds. 1. Non-interference or balance. 2. Cause and effect or imbalance. 3. Retribution or rebalance. 4. Assumption or completion or balance. 5. Polarity or balance. 6. Silence or balance. 7. Compensation or substitution or rebalance. The spiritual law of non-interference has been manifested in social, moral, religious, and philosophical writings throughout the ages, back to the dim memory of early spiritual evolution. Although it is the most familiar law, it is still a source of perplexing anxiety. The golden rule: do unto others as you would have them do unto you, is a manifestation of the law of non-interference, best known to school children. Grant that I may not criticize my neighbor until I have walked a mile in his moccasins, is a well-known manifestation of the same law, observed and preserved by the American Indians. Many of the ancient proverbs passed on from culture to culture, race to race, religion to religion, also reflect non-interference. The Ten Commandments, as brought down from the mountain by the Savior Moses, were also manifestation of the same law, as were also the teachings of the Saviors, Krishna, Buddha, and Christ. One manifestation of the law of non-interference used in Ekankar is expressed in three parts. 1. No state of being shall intrude or impose upon the physical, emotional, mental, or spiritual places of other states of being without the express request or permission. 2. No state of being shall trespass upon or invade the free will and private beingness of other states of being without the express request or permission. 3. No state of being shall convert, coerce, or change the state of consciousness, ideology, or behavior patterns of any state of being without the express request or permission. Many manifestations of this law are stated in the enlightening work, the Shariat Ki Sugmat, Book 1 and 2, written by Sri Paul Twitchell. Non-interference expresses balance, going neither to the right nor to the left, remaining balanced in the middle. Having no wants or desires, but remaining balanced in the middle. Being neither for nor against, remaining balanced in the middle. All beings must be given the opportunity to learn of and rise above the delusions, projected and reflected images of the lower negative worlds. 2. The spiritual law of cause and effect has also been manifested in social, moral, religious, and philosophical writings. Newton's three laws are scientific manifestation of this law. The most frequently quoted of the three: for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction, clearly demonstrates this law. Cause and effect is the volatile state of unbalance. The tremendous energy that was utilized as the preservation, cohesiveness of the state of balance has been released to create disunity, disharmony, havoc, pain and suffering within and between states of being, states of matter, and states of association. The irony of the law of cause and effect is that it is self-perpetuating. Each effect in turn becomes a new cause, precipitating new effect. To stop the process, recognize the cause. The process is reflected in the Hegelian philosophical principle of action-reaction, stating thesis, antithesis equal synthesis, which becomes the new thesis. Nature itself provides spectacular proof of this process, expanding and contracting surface masses on the earth create internal stresses and strains. These in turn create great pressure that are relieved by sinkings, upheavals, quakes, and eruptions. With new surface conditions, the state is set for a replay of the same action-reaction. A fast-moving vehicle colliding with a fixed immovable object is a classical example of cause and effect. The impact with disintegration following is awesome to witness. Social philosophers are keenly aware of cause and effect. Their writings and actions agitate educational, cultural, and political upheavals, revolutions, and tremendous bloodshed. Moral philosophers are constantly embroiled in traumatic circumstances, pitting ideology against ideology with the zeal of dedicated crusaders. Religious philosophers willingly sacrifice entire states of being in order to advance secular beliefs through the exclusion of others. Ignorance, intolerance, bigotry, dismay, and fear always prevail when a state of balance is disrupted into a state of unbalanced cause and effect. Unbalance is also interference. Cause and effect are brought into play when the spiritual law of non-interference is violated, ignored, or deliberately challenged. This can happen between spiritual planes, universes, planets, masses, individuals, and also within any given individuals. Common individual violation are the use of tobacco, alcohol, drugs, poison, hallucinogens, narcotics, hypnosis, mental telepathy, psychic phenomena, mediumship, seances, projective prayer circles, passive meditation circles, or any other physically, emotionally, or mentally induced methods that will forcefully create unbalance. Thank you for listening. Stay tuned for the next reading or next chapter. Never.